Hey everybody, this is Andy. I hope you are doing well physically and mentally. And if you can, get out there and fish. It's a great way to reduce your stress levels and get back to nature and stay healthy mentally. So if you can do it, get out there. I've been going down to the Jersey Shore during the late days of July and the early days of August with this very hot weather in South Jersey. I figured it's better to go down to the shore and catch some fish that I'm going to take home and, you know, enjoy probably 10 degrees lower temperatures down there rather than staying inland and baking on the boat fishing for bass or crappie. So also, I haven't been able to get out too much just because of, you know, mostly other responsibilities that I've had to do. And I'm sure all of you have those responsibilities as well. But anyway, in this video, I made some adjustments. I went down to the jetty at the lighthouse, and I fell actually in my last video. And so I put on some my wading boots with cleats, and that made a huge difference. I mean, I didn't slip at all. Those are really essential for those rocks that are right next to the lighthouse. The rocks that are down further away from the lighthouse, those are not so bad. You're not really gonna go down on the edge, you know, down the edge on those steep rocks that that are real slick. But by the lighthouse, some of those rocks are real slick and you can't even tell, they look dry. So, you know, I saw a couple of kids down there in Crocs, and you know, I would say do not let your kids walk on those rocks by the lighthouse, you know, immediately by the lighthouse. Those are slick. I mean, if they're up high, they'll probably be all right, but there's a quite a big gap in between the rocks as well. I would just warn them about that. And also fishermen, be careful, you know, if you're over there.
Water's churned up a little bit.
I also attached a handle to my net to extend my ability to bring those fluke in over the rocks. It's probably something I'm not going to do again because what I realize is you can just swing the fish up. If you have heavy enough test on your reel, you can just swing the fish up and just drop it into your net that's laying there and then carry the fish over. So that's probably right the best way to do it. I'm sure if you fish this jetty, you already know that. But I wouldn't go under 20-pound test, though, if you're going to do that, because you have to be able to swing that fish over without it breaking the line. So that was an adjustment that I made that I don't think I'm going to do again. It did help with one of the fish in the videos.
Got a good fish here coming up. Oh yeah, it's got to be a keeper there. Now I'm going to be able to get him out.
Oh, nice fluke.
Yeah. Let's see if we can get him here. Is he on the gill? No. I don't know if he's a keeper. Let's see. His net worked out though. Let's see if he is. Nah, he looks short. Looks short. Yeah, he's about 16, I think. I'm guessing 16. Yeah. He felt bigger. We can get him off of here. There we go. That's in his tooth. There he goes. We're going down there. Probably not a keeper. About 16, I'm gonna say. Little guy. Let's swing him up. There you go. Gone. Put some of that on there. Some of that slime on there. Put it on there, get the scent. I don't know, probably a short. Yeah, he's little guy.
Another little one.
On the teaser.
See if we can get this guy up. On the teaser. See that there?
It's on a new color here. It's my pink lemonade color. Not a keeper. Gotta be 18. Oh, he got on the teaser too. I don't know if I'm gonna get him in now. Well, let's see. I can. Yeah, let's just pull him up. He comes off, he comes off. Ah, he's maybe 15.
Too small. Little guy.
Hitting on the teaser.
Not this guy, this is like a otter tail gulp combo. Let's see if we can camouflage that a bit.
Maybe I can talk to you more, you caught one right
there. Yeah.
What's that one? Little guy, bucktail, no gulp. Here now.
It's the keeper, I think. Shit, he's flying. Nah, maybe not. He felt big. He's not that big. I don't know why he feels so big. He's on the teaser. I don't know why. He felt bigger. Probably because he was snagged. Dang it. On the teaser. Let's get that there. Wow.
Little guy. Little fluke.
Little one on the blue trues
with a fluke strip, actually. Oh, there he goes. Yeah. He's down in the rocks. Gone.
I wasn't ready for that. Got hit as soon as it came on. There we go. Probably a ray. Yeah, it's a ray. So, huh? Nah, this is fine. I like the little ones. This might be a fluke, actually. He might have been... that's a fluke. No, it's a bluefish. I'll cut him up for bait. Yeah, I'll cut him up for bait. Oh, I just threw it. Yeah, make some strip bait out of him. I don't know. You said you want him? You want him? Yeah, I got enough. I got flounder.
You know what? I just
I have it from my last catch. Yeah, that's what I caught this guy on.
Fluke skin. Well, little guy, little tiny, little sea bass. Baby sea bass. Foul hook him too, in the eye. He was good. Gone. Ah, it's a ray. Got a ray. That's probably what was on before. Bring this motherfucker in. Bring him in. Gonna take my jig again? Is that what you're gonna do? Look at that thing. Man. Rock, there he is. Got a nasty stinger. I can get that out, actually. Oh. Cow nose. Get my jig. I gotta have that jig in there. He's got my jig in his mouth. He's still there. Maybe I'll net him, get my jig back. All right, let's see if we can get this guy without getting stung by this mole. Come on, get in there. Oh, there he is. Gotta watch that stinger, dude. Try to get my jig back. Cow nose, right? You can. Why? You want them? I don't think there's a limit on them. Yeah, you cut the wings off. You could use it for bait too.
What kind of fish is it?
It's a cow nose ray. Cow nose ray. I gotta watch for that stinger though, man. Yeah, well, they'll sting you. See that stinger right there? I got my foot on him. Nobody wants to keep them, do they? Out. You guys don't want him, do you? I'm gonna let him go. There he goes. And I got my jig back. Usually don't get that, man. Oh yeah, here we go. What this is here, something big. Oh, it's a good fluke. It's a good fluke. How am I going to get this thing up? Let's see if we can get him. Doormat. This is going to be pretty tough here. Let's get him. Oh. Yeah, keeper, finally. Time to go home. Out of here.
at my jig. God damn it. Oh, man. Oh. That's why you always bring a net. Oh, Jesus. And I lost my jig, too. My jig is down there. I can get the jig. Is the food still there is the question. I should have stringered him right there on the rock. That was stupid of me to try to get him over to that side. That was a good size fluke. I was probably 21, I'm guessing. It was dinner. So yeah, that was a loss. It was getting late, so if I did bring that fish home, I would have had to fillet it and then prepare it. Probably, I would have been home at like 9:30 at night. So we had Popeyes instead, so it was no big deal. He can live another day and maybe he'll get bigger and I'll get him then. So, we'll get more. So what I did realize though is not to go below 20 pound test. I actually had reduced my line to 12 pound test thinking that I'd be able to cast further, but I actually was casting further with the 20 pound test. So, that was a mistake. But you live and you learn.
Got a hit right here. Been pretty dead today for me anyway. Junk fish. He had been just rocks. Oh, something just.
Oh, we got one. We got one. Looks like a good one. It's a good one. Shit, how am I gonna pull this guy up? This is a keeper here.
Oh yeah, come on.
Oh no, he's not a keeper. I don't know if he is. He might be.
If he is, I'm going.
I'm headed home. Let's see. Got my little tape measure. There he is. Nah, he's probably about 16. Let's say he's 16. Nah, maybe only 15. 17. Yeah, he's going back. Short. Fluke. Ah, there he goes. Cool. Gone.